tonight. What the worst that I could say? Well, things are better if I stay.
And when I start the My Chem Museum.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure there's a few season ticket holders to that museum in this room. Let's go back to the floor for another question. This is from, this is a great name. Sapphire Bleach. Wow. That sounds like a band.
If you could have one superpower, what would it be?
I think I traditionally choose flight when asked that question.
The ability to control time.
Yeah. That'd be a good one, though.
And I would just sleep. Stop everything and just sleep.
I think I don't think I'd get bored of flying. Yeah. I'd have to go with flight. Mm.
I think probably teleportation, so you could just be, we could be here at the gig and then play the show and then go back home or something.
That's
so
a good one, too.
I think invisibility would be quite a good one.
Invisibility would be good.
Yeah.
But it'd be, like, too tempting. There's too much bad stuff to do.
Yeah. True. You become, like, the greatest nosy Parker. Is it true that that 9/11 seriously made you question what you were going to do with your life and seriously made you say, the band is what I want?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it had that effect on a lot of people. I distinctly remember the train ride home, like the emergency train rides home, people calling, like proposing to people, people making plans, people changing. I think I heard people quit their job and stuff. So I obviously it was affecting everybody in a really dramatic way. And then, you know, music was always this thing I secretly wanted to do. That I wasn't sure if I was any good at, but I said, well, I'm going to try anyway.
In this country, I know when you guys were first making serious headway, some of the British press had certain things to say about the look and the sound of the band, and there was a great deal sort of negativity from you to the British press and vice versa. Was that stuff that happened around the world, or was that just unique to the wonderful British tabloid press we have?
In certain places, wherever you would see it affect the culture. And so when it would affect the youth culture, they could have parents and people just getting cautious or nervous about something, and then you'd have tabloids ready to kind of take their money and sell them a paper. So that any country where that was a thing, you know.
Absolutely. Did you find that upsetting? Did you find that disturbing?
Absolutely, because it just hurt the kids. It didn't hurt us. Like, we, you know, it drew so much attention to the Black Parade that it made it this monumental thing here. Like, it really affected things here. Like, that was really great. I wish maybe it happened sometimes in slightly different ways. But I think because we wrote it out, it happened because it was a great record. You know?
Were you also then surprised by the reaction that it got, positive and negative, this look, this sound? I mean, you couldn't avoid that record, and you couldn't avoid your band for a while.
That was weird.
Strange.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I remember there was one trip we came over here, and we were just walking down a street, and there was all these shop windows, and they had all, like, Black Parade jackets in it. I was like, what? Really? Yeah. It's crazy.
What did you do?
I don't even like wearing this.
What did you do with that stuff after? Because I co-play with their Viva La Vida stuff. Right. They sort of they gave it to charity. They donated it to charity. I know some of them even just set fire to it. Enough.
Everything like that I keep. That's the only stuff I keep. Everything else, I it's weird. I can't hold on to anything. I throw everything away, every ticket, scrap of paper, everything. But I keep every single uniform that I've ever constructed for myself, I guess, in a closet. So I have all that stuff.
Yeah, I still have mine hanging up in my closet, so.
You've always got a cracking Halloween outfit to
wear
there, haven't you? Let's go back to the fans for some more questions. Is it Christy Mossman?
Yeah.
Hi, Christy. What's your question?
If you could collaborate with any musician from history, who would it be and why?
I'm really bad at these.
I am too, but I know there's.
We're giving you the whole of history.
No. The entirety. David Bowie.
Yeah.
Be awesome.
Why David Bowie? I mean, I think I probably know why David Bowie.
Right. I think because he's a true artist. He's completely always done what he wanted. He's changed so much record to record, and I completely look up to him. And I definitely think he's a genius. I think nothing really ever seemed to get in the way of him making his art, and that's admirable.
He had this amazing way of having the image, but the image not detracting from what the music was doing.
Yeah.
And actually, he could have just been wearing brown trousers, you know, with a side parting, and it would have been just as entertaining as what he was doing.
I think so. Yeah.
Is the image sort of styled? Does someone think about it, or is it all organic from the band?
I definitely think a lot about it. I do a lot of drawings. We talk about it though. We come up. Everybody comes up kind of with their own variations.
Yeah, it kind of it has to be something that you would, you know, actually wear. Mm. You know, and represent your personality a little bit more. But when we do like the uniform thing, yeah, definitely think about it.
One of the things I wanted to ask you is about what U.S. radio is like at the moment, because you know you go over to America, you turn on the radio, and it's all pop music. It's all American Idol, Rihanna, Katy Perry, Justin Bieber, and it's kind of hard for some bands to get the airplay and therefore the recognition. It took Kings of Leon a hell of a long time to get the recognition in the States that they had here.
Right.
How is it for you? How is it for the rest of the rock music scene in America?
It's weird. If you came out with a record in the 90s, you're still getting played on the radio.
So Faith No More, Pearl Jam, that kind of stuff. Yep.
Lots of Sublime still gets played, and it's crazy. I mean, you know, some of those songs are really great, but like, you know, there's always new stuff, and it's just it's weird to me that you know new rock music doesn't get its fair shake.
And the rock radio shrunk. So you're referring to the larger pop thing.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. It's hard for anybody. It's just as a fan of music, it's disheartening because you're like, you know, rock. It's almost right now. You just feel like rock doesn't have a place on the radio in America, but that's okay because these things kind of happen in shifts.
Although this shift does appear to have been the longest shift that I can recall for quite
some
time.
I agree with that. It's the scariest shift, you know, for sure.
True. Everybody's always like, "Nah, it's gonna end anytime now." Like this pop music thing is gonna end, and it's you know.
Well, I mean, I don't want to sit here and slag off individuals, but what is it? I can't work out what it is about someone like Justin Bieber, for example, that has had this explosion.
He's kind of just like, he's doing this thing that, you know, Jonas Brothers, New Kids on the Block. I mean, we've, you know, so that's that void.
It goes back to sort of Jimmy Osmond.
Yeah, absolutely. It goes that far back. So that's like kind of pure pop, just like somebody that's a great dancer and, you know, does all that stuff a lot. Like, you know, I don't know. I couldn't tell you what it is. I had a theory about it like a month ago about pop and why it was. Maybe in some ways because certain kinds of pop, not the real dumb stuff, but maybe the smarter stuff like Gaga or Kanye, like it's done the job of being art and being smart now, whereas rock used to do that job. Mm. And I think that now some pop acts are doing it, so maybe it's giving rock a run for its money.
Thank God that there's a few bands just still doing what they do best. And
yeah.
You know, thank God for bands like My Chemical Romance. Okay, we got a question here from Maisie Newland.
Hi.
Hello, Maisie.
Hi. Your videos are crazy and action-packed, but which was the most fun to film?
Man, I think either Nana or Sin.
Yeah, those were two of the... I mean, we just had a blast running around and, you know, creating the story as we went. And, you know, we were running around in the desert with ray guns and a muscle car.
Everything felt so new, too, when we were doing that video. It really felt like, you know, especially, too, because we had been talking about and living with these designs and characters and the record for, you know, about, like, 6 or 7 months at that point. And it felt like this, like, huge release to do that video.
Especially, too, with Nana. Like, I mean, he's directing it, so it's like... the craziest shit you can think of, just do it and have fun with it, you know, as opposed to like some dude that's like, oh no, I want to get this angle, and you're just like, no, you blow this up.
You've got the best jobs. Yeah. You got the best jobs in the world, haven't you?
That's how I felt that day. Yeah. That's how I felt that day. I was like, this is the greatest ever. And you know, we all know each other so well, like even collaborating or coming up with the uniforms for them, like that was easy because I know them. And when I'm directing this video, like I know them. So it's like, I don't know, I knew what to look for and what to grab and what they were going to be the best at.
Can you see yourselves making film?
I would love it.
It'd be really awesome.
I mean, obviously Green Day have turned American Idiot into a musical, and there's still ongoing talk of it being turned into a film. I mean, your music, I mean, it just would make a perfect film, wouldn't it?
A lot of stuff was happening during Parade, and I'd always felt like it'd be best to wait. You know, I felt like it was so soon. Like, I'd like to see what it meant in 15, 20 years. And then maybe it's more interesting, kind of like when they did The Who on Broadway. But I feel a little differently about Danger Days. It feels like there's more possibilities there, maybe because it's less theatrical.
Hmm.
I have a hard time with Broadway. I don't really connect with it in certain ways.
Well, maybe not Broadway. Maybe a movie then. Maybe a film would work better.
I like theater. You know, like I was just talking about it last night. I had an amazing experience seeing... you know, The Black Rider years ago, and it I like that kind of stuff. So.
Yeah, I mean, your live shows, particularly for the Black Parade, incredibly visual, stunning. I mean, you could almost sit there with your fingers in your ears, and it was just as fun to watch it as it was to listen to it. What have you got in store? What have you got planned for these live shows that are coming up to support this album? Anything you can tell us?
These shows are, I mean, it's a really good spread of, like, old stuff and new stuff. And there's a hell of a light show that's going on. We kind of stripped everything back, so it's really just, I mean, to me, it's more of, like, an intimate thing with the band, you know, where it's the band just playing as opposed to, like, you know, having all the bells and whistles going on.
Is that important post what was before it, really, to say, actually, bottom line, we can do all of that,
right?
But still the four of us make one hell of a tight ship.
I think that's, you know, it's harder to do that, to keep people's interest and, you know, and have people have a good time without, like, you know, Godzilla walking across the stage and stepping on shit.
That would be awesome.
That would be cool.
Tonight, what do I say I could say? Well, things are better.